Over the past 30 years, observations with the Hubble Space Telescope have shown that all galaxies have black holes at their centers. Bigger galaxies have bigger black holes. Nature knows how to make black holes over a staggering range of masses, from star corpses a few times the mass of the Sun to monsters tens of billions of times more massive. That's like the difference between an apple and the Great Pyramid of Giza. Astronomers published the first ever picture of a black hole and its event horizon, a 7 billion solar mass beast at the center of the M87 elliptical galaxy. It's over 1,000 times bigger than the black hole in our galaxy. These black holes are dark most of the time, but when their gravity pulls in nearby stars and gas, they flare into intense activity and pump out a huge amount of radiation. Massive black holes are dangerous in two ways. If you get too close, the enormous gravity will suck you in, and if they are in their active quasar phase, you'll be blasted by high-energy radiation. How bright is a quasar? Imagine hovering over a large city like Los Angeles at night. The roughly 100 million lights from cars, houses, and streets in the city correspond to the stars in a galaxy. In this analogy, the black hole in its active state is like a light source, 1 inch in diameter in downtown LA, that outshines the city by a factor of hundreds or thousands. Quasars are the brightest objects in the universe. The biggest black hole discovered so far weighs in at 40 billion times the mass of the Sun, or 20 times the size of the solar system. Whereas the outer planets in our solar system orbit once in 250 years, this much more massive object spins once every 3 months. Its outer edge moves at half the speed of light. Like all black holes, the huge ones are shielded from view by an event horizon. At their centers is a singularity, a point in space where the density is infinite. We can't understand the interior of a black hole because the laws of physics break down. Time freezes at the event horizon, and gravity becomes infinite at the singularity. The good news about massive black holes is that you could survive falling into one. Although their gravity is stronger, the stretching force is weaker than it would be with a small black hole, and it would not kill you. The bad news is that the event horizon marks the edge of the abyss. Nothing can escape from inside the event horizon, so you could not escape or report on your experience. According to Stephen Hawking, black holes are slowly evaporating. In the far future of the universe, long after all stars have died and galaxies have been wrenched from view by the accelerating cosmic expansion, black holes will be the last surviving objects. The most massive black holes will take an unimaginable number of years to evaporate, estimated at 10 to the 100th power, or 10 with 100 zeros after it. The scariest objects in the universe are almost eternal. Don't forget to watch the video on the right and subscribe. Thanks for being part of Cosmoknowledge.